Tate, Ogden Bourne, Rhys Martin and Greg Eastwood. The player of 25 tests for New Zealand will be the experienced player in the lineup this evening. Referees this evening, Jared Sutton and also Chris Butler, as the Panthers kick things underway by their new recruit, James Maloney. And it's up to the Bulldogs to get us underway for the very first run this evening. And there's going to be plenty of people trying to push their way right now tonight for those first grade honours. The big boys always take them up nice and early. And this time it was with Renoff Tuomunga in the number 10. Greg Eastwood, the veteran, takes the ball forward. Not only 25 tests for New Zealand, but also 226 NRL matches. So no doubt we'll be seeing plenty from Greg Eastwood tonight as Rhys Martin takes the ball forward 40 metres out from his own end of the field.
It's been really good to see Greg Eastwood get through some training sessions too, Brad. So he's been training really hard, particularly the last month, and get through a lot of contact out on the field too. So expect him to go well today.
He's the last. And the kick coming through from Josh Cleland, picked up by Dylan Edwards in the fullback spot tonight for the Panthers. And they are littered full of talent, all NRL players, all of note in their team. The youngster Christian Crichton takes the ball up now. He's the Penrith junior. And he's got the ball just 5 metres short of the halfway line. Peter Wallace at dummy half picks up Josh Mansour. And when you do hear the players listed tonight, you'll recognise all the names out there for the Panthers. Big effort tonight for the Bulldogs to really push their opportunities this year, because they've got a big night ahead of them. Here's Trent Marin down the short side. Nice bit of work there. Viliami Kikau brought down a beautiful tackle down around the legs on the last. Now coming for the Panthers, here's Maloney. Gives a nice long pass and just goes to ground. That's picked up. Nathan Cleary comes back around. Bit of pressure out on that left side. Going up, and the ball comes back down into the hands of a Bulldogs player. And they've saved the day at the back there for the Dogs. Good end to the set from the Panthers. The Bulldogs are alive and well here early on, still nil all.
Yeah, it looked like Bergamon might have got a touch to that and could have gone forward, but they cleaned up pretty well in the end.
Fa'amanu Brown going in there, playing in the hooking role, trying to force his way through. Behind the likes of Michael Leisha as he made his move over from the Sharks. Here's another run again from Tuomunga. What a work for the big boys early.
Sorry, Brad. Big Renoff's another young one that's been here with the Bulldogs since SG Ball back in 2013, and really getting close to getting that NRL debut, I think.
Tell you what, Regan Campbell-Gillard came through on Josh Cleland. Pretty lucky not to give away the penalty there, big Regan. Tackling in the air after kicking the football. Here's Dean Farre now out on the right centre position. Another one of the quality outside backs. The other side is Tyrone Peachy. Here's another good run there from Crichton. He's come in from the left wing to make that run. And a lot of solid work. In fact, the right wing, as Mansour goes back to his left wing, and James Tarmo takes the next charge forward. Now down the left. Merrin on the edge, throws the dummy, goes himself, looks back on the inside, finds Wallace, now in the hands of Campbell-Gillard. Big boys come back through the middle, but the defence is right there up against it for the Bulldogs. Last tackle now coming for the Panthers. Here's the kick from Maloney, looking for Mansour. Oh, the ball bounces and ricochets into the hands of Lachlan Lewis, who comes down with it, and then he's thrown over the sideline as the ball comes forward off the hands there of Lewis. A lot of pressure there on Tom Carr out on the right wing. And the Bulldogs come up with an error, and the Panthers will have another set on their line.
That's two good end of sets by the Panthers in a row now, and they're getting good numbers around the ball, making it really hard for the Bulldogs to get a good result.
Famous name there, Lachlan Lewis. He's the nephew of the King, Wally.
Yeah. Yeah, he's come to the Bulldogs 2 or 3 years ago from the Canberra Raiders. And a good kid. You know, most of his football career has been in the halves, but he's really making a fist of playing in the centres.
Definitely got longer locks than the King.
He does, yeah. His dad, Scotty, was quite a player as well from the Valleys Diehards up in Brisbane. And not sure if he had a stint at Winner Manly as well, but good pedigree.
Well, I'm lucky I've got another Queensland legend next to me too, Brad Henderson. Oh, wow. We dragged him down here to join the Bulldogs under Des Hasler. All right, the Panthers now on the attack, just a couple of metres away now as Wallace gives the ball out now to Cleary. Going back across field, kick out comes back underneath. Tuamunga's been heavily involved, the number 10 for the Bulldogs in defence here early, along with Greg Eastwood. Wallace again now, goes out the back, finds Cleary, comes across. Ball goes in the hands now of Farre, comes back on the inside, a nice tackle underneath that time from the Bulldogs. That was Jeremy Marshall King, the man making the tackle, but looks like just up a little bit too quickly there, and the penalty goes to the Panthers. They're doing well, this Bulldogs team, defending nicely against the NRL caliber Panthers here in the trial. Goes out now to Cleary, out the back finds Maloney, turns it under for kick out towards the line, but he's brought down just shy of the try line. Big opportunity again for the Panthers, the weight of possession. First man play, trying to barge over the line. The ball comes out the back, does it? No. Referee Sutton says the ball has been knocked on. That's great defence there from the Bulldogs as all the boys come in and pat each other on the back.
And Greg Eastwood did a good job there, just on slowing the play, the ball down. But Penrith have got two really good big targets on the edge in Yeo and Kikau, so Bulldogs are going to have their handful contained in those two, particularly on a change of direction.
It's a fair start for this Bulldogs team. They've come in well. The players that they're really pushing hard for at the moment, those spots for Josh Cleland, we mentioned the number six. Players like Matt Frawley in front of him and obviously Kieran Foran not in the team tonight. So a real opportunity maybe for a guy like Josh Cleland to push into the NRL.
Yeah, Josh had a fantastic ISP season last year, and I know there's talk of him getting really close, and I think, you know, it's only a matter of time before it does happen for him. And if he stays consistent, I think he gets another good few games under his belt in the ISP. He's every chance.
We're also seeing these boys come through the under-20 system as well. We've had the pleasure of seeing a lot of these young boys come through. Here's Jaden Oakenbourne now.
Yeah, Jaden was one of ours last year and had an injury, disrupted year, had to have some shoulder surgery after about round 14 and missed the rest of the season. But again, Jaden's been with us since Harold Matts, and big things are expected of Jaden in years to come.
Well, the pass called forward there. Looks like maybe the one off the ruck from New Brown. And they'll bring it back now to pack down the scrum. The Panthers will have the ball on the Bulldogs' 30-metre line. A bit of pressure here coming now for the Bulldogs.
Pretty cool.
They held up quite nicely before, and they'll have another opportunity. And if you have a look at this Panthers back line, can't quite see it now, but tell you what, it is all the way back to the 40-metre line. Josh Mansour's back on his own 40. It's incredible. Just see how deep they are. They go that way now through Maloney. Out the back finds Edwards. Edwards wants to see a hole, but Lachlan Lewis closes it down nicely. Beautiful tackle underneath by young Lewis. Here's Peachy now, ever dangerous Tyrone Peachy. He's taking the ground now. Eastwood over the top. Come back out to the open side. Cleary looks inside, goes outside. A nice pass to Regan Campbell-Gillard. Too big and too strong. The numbers, the weight of possession there really told for the Panthers, and they score the first try here in the trial. It's 4-0. As you can see, it was Wallace looked inside and just too strong. Might have been Renoff to Tuamunga, who's done a lot of defence here early on in this trial match for the Doggies. Campbell Gillard just poked his nose through the hole. It's just too strong.
Yeah, they just took the line on with numbers there, didn't they? And probably sliding outside the ball a little bit too much. And Campbell Gillard did the rest, hit a really nice hole. Bulldogs just got to hang in there, I think, and get the football up the other end, take a bit of pressure off themselves. It's been all down their end at the moment. If they get to a kick a few times, they'll get their turn.
Also, too, no doubt that the Panthers will be rotating players. We're playing the unlimited interchanges through these trial matches, and they'll get an opportunity to play plenty of different guys on the field, as will the Bulldogs. And they'll all be pressing for the opportunity to shine this evening. And back at Belmore, it must be great to play a game of footy here at Belmore Sports Ground.
Yeah, it's fantastic. We only get two fixtures here a year, and this is our first trial here this year as well, so it's really good for the fans too. They get them so close to the action, and they never let us down whenever we play here. They turn out in their numbers, and we try to do our best to keep them happy, that's for sure.
Here's Nathan Cleary to have the extra 2 points. Makes no mistake. 6-0 is the score. What about the Panthers? They certainly don't need to worry about goal kicking. They've got James Maloney to back them up when Nathan Cleary decides he doesn't want to kick.
Yeah, they're not struggling, are they? Peter Wallace has probably hit a few in his day as well.
So just in regards to the teams that they've put out on the field tonight, the Panthers through Anthony Griffin, he played, a fairly strong team last week as well against a weakened Roosters outfit, and they got the victory. This week they've played their strongest possible outfit, without being disrespectful to anyone not chosen tonight, but from view tonight, it looks like their best squad. And last week, Dean Pay, the Bulldogs' new coach coming in, decided to go with a strongish team last week up in the Sunny Coast against the Raiders, but this week not so much. What's the thinking behind that?
I'm not too sure. I haven't really spoken to Dino about it, but you know, no doubt he has his reasons. I think a lot of the work they've been doing internally in their internal scrimmages and opposed sessions has been very physical, so the boys are still getting the work done. It might not be in the game format against opposition, but they're doing the work and working hard, and there are probably a few guys that just needed to have a decent off-season, like Clever Awards and guys, and some of the internationals, as well as giving Kieran some time to settle into his role. And I'm sure Dino knows exactly what he's doing.
He's been around, that's for sure, Dean Pay. Last tackle now for the Panthers. They've marched the football upfield, and Cleary puts it nice and high. Bergerman has another tough one, gets a bit of help at the fullback there from Kerrod Holland, who helped him out. Nice block there for Josh Bergerman, and they come up with the penalty. Nice work there with the Bulldogs, and just having back play, Viliami Kikau was a little bit dusty, the number 12 for the Panthers.
It's just going to relieve a little bit of pressure, that one. They've been hanging in there as best they can, the Dogs, and get the football up the other end now and try and turn the screws a bit on the Panthers.
Well, they have put themselves under all sorts of pressure with forward passes and some drop balls on the line as Jaden Oakenball goes forward once more. His dad's Nigerian, playing his footy, I believe, born in Sydney and a Bulldogs junior. And been likened to the likes of Jamal Idris in the past. Big jammer, used to play out on one of those edges, just like Jaden is.
Sure did. Very similar in looks, obviously, but Jaden's a great kid. He's a really strong work ethic and just a good person as well, so.
The Bulldogs now through Fa'amanu Brown down the left-hand side. They're doing it nicely now, the Bulldogs. First real chance of the football on the attack. They come back the open side through Greg Eastwood.
He's been busy, Beast.
He's dead set pushing for that NRL opportunity this year to come back into the squad. He's the kick across field now. Tom Carr is there. Josh Mantor takes it nicely. Gets a bit of support there also from Tyrone Peachy. Did Josh Mantor. But Tom Carr did well to put the pressure on. Now have to work it out from their own end of the field. They've run the ball strongly. He seems to have recovered well now, kick out. And on a beautiful warm day here in Belmore Sports Ground, temperature up to 32 degrees today in Sydney. Certainly the players are feeling it. Bulldogs were up in Sunny Coast last week for similar warm conditions, so they're not escaping the heat, are they, Brad?
They've even got the humidity this week down here as well, so poor guys, but they're getting through it. Got a good warm-up for it last week.
Kick on the last, it was from Cleary, looked to go for the 40-20, but Holland was back nicely to pick up the football. Still the sun shining as the time goes down now, just short of 6:45 here in Sydney.
Slowly starting to turn into the arm wrestle here. This is what Dean I'll be really looking for, the boys to stay in the grind. Trying to see if the Panthers can break before they do.
How many players in front of us?
There's Tom Carr coming in from the right wing. Helensburg Jr., previously in the Dragons squad through Illawarra Cutters, and now Lachlan Lewis takes the ball forward. Last tackle, we may have lost it there, trying to get up and push the play. He has there, Lewis. Knocked it on. Referee Chris Butler says you'll have to pack down a scrum, son, so they don't get to their last. And that pressure they were starting to mount the Bulldogs, they've turned the ball over.
Yeah, he's just a bit too keen, wasn't he? All they needed was to play the ball then. Didn't have to be a quick one.
So just looking at about the year ahead for the Bulldogs. No doubt one of the things that Dean Pay will have to work on from last year is the attack. The Bulldogs were 16th in attack. Has anything improved over the off-season under Dean Pay and the coaching staff to improve on that number?
Yeah, absolutely. You know, it's obviously it's different different coaching staff and different ideas, but you know, the boys are really enthusiastic about the plays that Dino's brought in. You know, obviously it's don't want to let too many cats out of the bag, but you know, they're executing really well at training, and I think if they can take the way they've been training onto the paddock, they're going to be in good shape. But I don't think points will be a problem for them this year.
Good news for Bulldogs fans as Trent Merrin now takes the ball up the middle, 20 metres away from the try line, off a cheeky run from James Maloney, who's looking for those holes down on the right side of the Bulldogs' defence. They go to the right now in the bright sunshine. Cleary throws the pass, and that's Isaiah Yeo takes the tackle now.
Great tackle by Marshall King. What a big man.
Here's the kick. Little one from Cleary in behind the line. Oh, Tyrone Peachy goes through his legs. Can you believe it? It was right there for Tyrone Peachy just to dive onto the football. Josh Cleland couldn't get across in time, but the referee has called all the players offside. But a little bit embarrassing there for Tyrone Peachy, who just got clean bowled.
Went straight over the top of it.
Here you see now, just that kick through. Oh, poor old Tyro Peachy can have a giggle about that one, but it came back for the penalty players in front of the kicker.
Really important the Dogs can end their set like they did the last one. If they turn it over on last tackle, 1 metre from a corner post, you know, they've done well. So they've just got to stay patient, keep in the grind, keep bending them. Eventually some will turn.
And you can see that the Panthers aren't going for that physical game. They're not trying to throw the ball around too much. And the Bulldogs holding on nicely, just 6 points to nil, as we'll see a change about to be made. And you'll see plenty of those changes in this trial match, that's for sure. He's Cleland down the right side, tries to step off the right, and then brought to ground. He's a player of real talent you're looking forward to, about to get the ball off Eastwood, but it's Ofahiki Ogden, came over from the Warriors this year.
Yeah, I don't know too much about Offa, but in terms of training, he's been really impressive. So he's a big human, runs the ball very hard, and I know he's a noted defender, so looking forward to some big things from Offa.
Nice work at fullback there by Dylan Edwards.
Yeah, he's classy, isn't he?
Certainly knew where the ball was going, reading it nicely. Here's Josh Mansour, one of the hardest runners of the football.
What a hit.
From the back three. Gets to his feet now finally, and Crichton comes over from the right wing. So many teams do it well, don't they? They use their back three to get them out of trouble and allows the forwards to recover. Penrith are doing it nicely. Here's Maloney turning it back underneath for kick out. Oh, beautiful offload now to Peter Wallace. He's brought down, a tackle that needed to be made by that man Ogden. Last play coming now. Peachy goes across field. Cleary turns it underneath, finds Edwards. Last tackle still, flicks it out the back into the safe hands there of Fahamanu Brown. And the Bulldogs defend it nicely as we have a player down injured in the back here for the Panthers.
Yeah, the Dogs did really well to survive then. They got numbers back in front of the ball at least. Panthers are starting to open them up a little bit on some change of direction, particularly off Maloney and through kick out. Good chance for them to get a break too right now. The stoppage won't hurt them.
James Maloney is the man that's getting some attention on the halfway line.
Yeah, I think he might have got hit on a bit of inside pressure, keeping him honest.
The swap with Matt Moylan. Panthers have got their man in James Maloney. There you see now, what an amazing footballer James Maloney has been over a very long established career. Over many teams too, but every team he goes to seems to improve that team to great success.
Yeah, success everywhere he goes, isn't there? Very competitive.
Still 6 points to nil. Here the Panthers lead the Bulldogs at Belmore Sports Ground. The Bulldogs, youngsters, let's call them youngsters, and we'll pay that respect to Greg Eastwood, who's doing a lot of work out there in the middle.
He'd be happy with that.
But they are really standing up nicely here, the Dogs. Here's Tom Munger again, still out there too. The big man, he's doing nicely up front. Defensively strong, a lot of carries. That is he's certainly something Dean Pay will be keeping a close eye on. He's Reece Martin out on the edge. Martin now brought down on the Panthers side of halfway. Third week trial matches. Here the Bulldogs taking on the Panthers. Panthers with their game last week against the Roosters, and the Bulldogs took on the Raiders. Here's Cleland now on the last. Gets an accidental touch. Lachlan Lewis almost with the hands. Ball comes forward, and it is a knock-on there to the Bulldogs. A changeover on the last, and the Panthers do nicely in defence to hold out the Bulldogs.
Yeah, nearly a little bit of fortune there for Lachie Lewis, but it wasn't to be.
Here's Josh Mansell bringing the football back for the Panthers. As I mentioned, Darlan Watson is Zalesniak. He's out with a high ankle sprain. Likes of Tyrone May recovering from the ACL injury from last year. Tyrone Phillips, who they brought over from the Bulldogs, he's out with potentially a pec injury. So a bit of a tough blow there for Tyrone Phillips. Now the Panthers out through Cleary. Finds Yeo, tries to get on the outside there of Marshall King, who does nicely in defence. It's a couple of times now we've seen Jeremy Marshall King stand up for the Dogs. Coming back across the open side, turning underneath Big Reed and Campbell Gillard. And once again, the Dogs, three in the tackle, standing up nicely. Last tackle now coming for the Panthers. Down the short side, it's Cleary. Puts up another kick. Holland is back waiting for it. They're charging through at him. Goes up nicely, Kerrod Holland, and brings it down. Safe under the high ball. He's played out in the centres in the past in the NRL for the Doggies, and also been a noted goal kicker over a number of years. In his 27 NRL matches, has Kerrod Holland.
Yeah, outstanding goal kicker, Dutchie. And I think, from what I've seen, he's only been back training at fullback possibly the last 2 to 3 weeks, but looks like he's definitely grown a leg there and looks pretty enthusiastic for the gig.
Well, the versatility, it can make you or break you in the game of rugby league.
It sure can.
Kerrod Holland making a fist of it tonight at fullback. He's Oakenbore again. Been busy, a few touches of the footy tonight already in this first half of the trial. 20 minutes gone. 6 points to nil. The Panthers lead the Bulldogs. Asipeli Fine on the field now for the Bulldogs. Makes some nice metres up the middle. Here's Eastwood now. Pops the ball out the back. Bit of movement now in the hands of Reece Martin. Players pretty busy here at the moment. Nice to see Marshall King popping his nose up there in that front line. Well, pushing the back, a pressure from Josh Mansour, and he's forced the mistake. Referee Butler seeing something there, maybe knocked down by the hand there of Josh Mansour. Not just a push in the back, but also maybe a push onto the football that's knocked it forward. A few confused looks and faces out there from the Panthers, but the Bulldogs, they'll be happy to have the scrum back down. And just 30 metres away from the try line, love to see this Bulldogs team cross over and put some pressure here on the Panthers. Just some of those players joining the Bulldogs this year. We mentioned New Brown from the Sharks, Kieran Foran from the Warriors. You've got Clay Priest also from the Raiders, Aaron Woods from the Tigers, and another Moses Suli, a late pickup from the West Tigers. And as I say that, it looks like it wasn't a knock-on from the Panthers, but that in fact it was from the Bulldogs. So lucky here they are, the Panthers. Either that, maybe they should have allowed Josh Mansour to run away and potentially score a try.
Yeah.
Here they are on the attack now. James Tamo gives the ball out the back to Cleary. Jaden Oakenbull was up, putting lots of pressure that time on the halfback. Down the short side now, the Panthers. Maloney holds the ball up for Yeo. He's still on his feet, trying to get the extra metres towards the line. Last tackle now for the Panthers. Pretty decent set it is too. They spread it out to the left. Here's the kick. Coming up, chasing through. Kick-outs there. They're flying up high. Oh, nicely done to bring the ball down. That was Lachlan Lewis. Tell you what, he's not afraid to have a go, is he, Lewis? A couple of times now we've seen him put his body on the line for his team.
That's a brave catch, that one, too. Got up with his back towards the defence. He did well.
Trying to work the football out now. It's the toughest thing to do in rugby league. Defensive line set. Got to bend your back. Try and get that ball up forward. He's Asipeli Fine once more. Not much of Fine, but he tell you what, he goes hard.
He's a tough guy.
Here's another run up now through the middle. It looks like Francis Toolau.
It's good to see Johnny Olive coming in and getting a carry as well. I think the Penrith back five have been particularly effective. It's good to see the Bulldogs back five starting to do some work as well.
Yeah, picked up John Olive from the Titans, played there the last couple of years. 9 NRL games for them and also 1 for the Bunnies back in 2015 for John Olive.
Where's he going?
And here's Mansour again. He only knows one way. It's nice
so
and hard.
Powerful, isn't he? So powerful. That second effort in the tackle to get down, get through.
Solid tackle again, coming in from Lachlan Lewis, gaining the applause from his fans that have turned up tonight. And the Bulldogs defensively sound here in the middle at the moment. Panthers are nice and tight, go through Maloney, ducks under one there from Oakenbaugh. And also get some help from Marshall King. Last tackle now for the Panthers. Doing well to slow up the play down now. Comes across to Cleary. He'll look to kick, Willie. Puts the kick in behind. Finally gets a second boot to it. And Josh Cleland out there in the covers takes a nice catch. So you can see these players, they're really putting in tonight, aren't they, for the Bulldogs. They're pushing for that opportunity to join into the NRL squad. There's certainly a great list of players in front of them. But Dean Pay is giving them the opportunity against a quality outfit tonight to prove their worth for the year.
Absolutely. Yeah, I think this is exactly what they would have been looking for. It is a quality lineup by the Panthers. And at the moment, you know, they're down 6 points against a top line NRL team. So they're definitely doing a great job.
Bulldogs now on their last tackle. Here's the kick over from Holland, who came up into the front line. And nicely done by Edwards again. Always on the spot. Knows how to find the football. Chase though from Ogden to put pressure there on Edwards. His man saw. Boy, offload out the back to nobody. Good pressure here from the Bulldogs. Finds it in the hands of Tyrone Peachy in broken play. The last play you want to see get the hands on the football. Very dangerous, Tyrone Peachy. His kick out once more. See very limited changes here from the Panthers. Anthony Griffin really trying to use this as a decent hit out. Warm conditions and players playing plenty of minutes out there in the middle.
Yeah, I think it's really important they get as much as they can out of their middles in particular, given round one obviously limited interchange, so need to see how far they can go and for how long.
Trent Merrin continuing on his offloading way in 2018, and now the last tackle comes, another kick here from Cleary. He's been busy with the kicks, and Josh Bergerman once again will be asked to take the bomb. Good defence and good help again from Kerrod Holland to come across to make the block play. It's something we see all too much these days, isn't it, Brad? The support from the back three.
Yeah, look, it's part of the process. You can try to run the chasers off the ball best you can. So it's a bit of an art form, but I know Dave Penner works really hard with our boys on it every week.
They've worked very well on doing it tonight.
Yeah, they've had to defuse some, haven't they?
And just the patience they're playing with at the moment is Jaden Oakenbaugh finds a nice little run up through the middle. He has been impressive with all of his touches tonight. Here's the kick on the last off the left foot. Edwards again in the right position. Coming across field, trying to pick up Josh Mansour. Showing his pace, but that's a nice chase there in defence from Fine. Here's Mansour now. Penrith Panthers looking to continue on after a good year in 2017, finishing in seventh spot. Made it through to the second week of the finals before going down to the Broncos. And after that penalty, Maloney puts them now 40 metres away from the try line, leading 6 points to nil.
Looks like Jared Anderson's just come onto the field to right centre. Lachlan Lewis going on over into left half to replace New Brown.
As you'll see, plenty of movement around, and thankfully I've got Brad Henderson here with me, the Bulldogs 20s coach, to talk you through a lot of these changes. And a lot of players fresh through his system in the 20s up through Intrust Super Premiership. You see good pressure there, forces the mistake from the Panthers. Double knock on, and the Bulldogs will have the scrum feet here just in front of their own post. Some of the young players coming through, you've got the 20s this year, but the players who've come up through to this grade in the Intrust Super Premiership now up forcing up into the NRL. Who are some of the players who are standing out? I mean, it's very tough putting a coach on the line in that regard. putting one over the other, but some of the kids who've left you in the 20 system to come up through into Intrust Super?
Oh, yeah, look, obviously, Jaden Knockerball, we've already spoken about Jaden a couple of times, but...
keep it up!
Holds him in really high regard, and look, it's not a matter of if but when with Jaden. He's just got to be patient, but he's a good kid. We know he'll get there, and this is just great exposure for him. So add to that Lachlan Lewis as well. He's come through our NYC system that 1 year after we got him from Penrith. Josh Bergerman's another one out there that scored the winning try in the trial against Canberra last week. So Bergs is another kid that every game ISP plays is closer to an NRL debut.
Well, they're certainly standing up tonight, the three people you mentioned. Also, Ogden here came over from the Warriors. He's been very solid around that middle third. Here's Reece Martin once again on the edge. And that man, Jared Anderson, who's come onto the right centre position. Crowd really starting to get into it now. They're starting to get behind their team. Trailing just by 6 points here in the trial. And this is a good trial for the fans to get out to and test their efforts in 2018. Last tackle now for Cleland. Puts the kick in. Ricochets off a player. Not sure he's played at that one there for the Panthers. Oh, referee Sutton's pretty happy that he has. Bit of disbelief there. Maybe got a bit of help from the touch judge here on this short side on the western side of the grandstand.
Yeah, left-hand decision, that one.
That's a good help there for the Bulldogs. Very close to the line. You mentioned Jaden Oakenbaugh trying to press through. He's playing in the back row, but tell you what, he's got the likes of Josh Jackson, Adam Elliott, David Clemmer of the back three at the moment in the back row. Then you've got a bench of the likes of Danny Fualalo, Raymond Fatala-Mariner, Clay Priest has joined the club. Greg Eastwood here pushing for an opportunity as well. You know, there's some incredible back rowers in front of him at the moment, but he really just has to keep pushing hard.
Yeah, there sure is. You know, you've been talking about Asapelli Finney as well, Reece Martin as well, also. But it doesn't have to happen now for Jake. I'm sure he knows that. It's all part of the learning process, is getting this exposure and going back to ISP and having a really, really consistent season and trying to get ready for when it could happen.
Lachlan Lewis playing in that sixth role at the moment, came in from playing on the centres. He played much half.
Yeah, look, he's mainly been a half. A Queensland junior representative for the Queensland under 18. So, and a good half came up from the Canberra Raiders as a half and played his first season here in NYC at half. So he's probably more familiar as a pivot than he is a centre these days, but that's quickly changing.
Well, here he is now with the ball. Linkland, oh, nice ball there, puts over. Reece Martin, nice work. He was outside him before, Martin. Now he's inside him, Lincoln Lewis, and he puts him over for a nice try. And he had a bit to do there too, Reece Martin. Plenty of strength, and he scores a nice try.
Yeah, nice little bouncy out line there from Reece. Probably coming against the grain a little bit. Just a good little change up there with Peachy. Trying to jam from the outside in, exposed Maloney and got Reece over the line. I think he might have scored a couple of tries like that in the World Cup for PNG last year. Good football, Reece.
When we talk about how much the coaches are watching these trial matches and who's turning up, who's putting in, and Anthony Griffin won't be happy about that edge defence here in the trial match and already under pressure. You know, they've had very limited football, haven't they, on the Panthers line, and they're almost wilted on the first or second attempt.
Yeah, well, I can't remember too many play the ball, 0 and 10, so it's good to see when they get down there they finally crack them. Nice bit of football from Lachlan Lewis.
Mentioned the goal-kicking exploits of Kerrin Holland. 62 goals in his NRL career.
Does a lot of work with Darryl Halligan every week. All the boys do, all our kickers. Chuck comes in and puts a lot of time and effort into him.
Wow. And you can see what an incredible kicker he was on the football.
Absolutely.
This will level up the scores here in the trial match if Kerrin Holland can bang it over. That's a beauty of a kick as well. 6 points all. The score now here in the trial at Belmore Sports Ground between the Bulldogs and the Panthers. And it's been a very good hit out. Dean Pay would be very happy with the youngsters he's seen performing this evening and a couple of veterans that are out there helping them as well.
It'll be interesting to see how Panthers respond to that. So they probably haven't had the best 10 minutes of football with a couple of errors, not getting to their end of sets. And when Bulldogs finally get down there on probably a dubious call on the sideline, they put them away, get 6 points on.
Here's James Maloney with the restart. I'm very interested to see when Anthony Griffin starts going to his bench and brings on some of the other players to give them an opportunity out there in the middle.
He's definitely pushing him out, isn't he?
The last of the sun starting to go down here at Belmore as Cleland pushes it out now to the try scorer Martin. There's Maloney getting a little bit aggressive out there on the edge. Obviously not happy with the try scored against him and now giving away the penalty. Starting to see some of the aggression we know of James Maloney, one of the cheeky players in the game of the NRL.
Yeah, he's outstanding, isn't he? He gets in your face. Obviously gets under your skin occasionally too, but he's such a competitor. Outstanding player.
Man who knows success wherever he goes.
Sure does.
Here go the Bulldogs to allow. Debuted last year, I think, against the Sharks. And around round 12, he's played about 9 games for the Bulldogs as Francis Tulau. Now coming back through this left side, he's Lewis almost falling over there, Lincoln Lewis. Setting up the try previously, Asapeli Fine. Nice little left foot step before the line. I was watching Roy Asatazi at the line almost for a second. Another Bulldogs pass player. Here's the football now off for Hickey Ogden. Last tackle now for the Bulldogs, 5 metres away. Can the Panthers line up this time defensively? Comes out the back. He finds Lewis, left foot kick. Bit of pressure on out here for Crichton. He steps up to it nicely and he takes the football from his own side of play and then goes into the end goal area, and it's been forced in. It'll come back for a goal line dropout. Nice kick across field from Lewis there. Good pressure from the Bulldogs. And you can't get a better kick than that. You want it just inside the field of play. And that's exactly what Lewis came up with.
Yeah, it was perfect, wasn't it? Then all the boys did the right thing by reacting with a real good chase and a good effort to keep Crichton in goal. They can build some pressure now. Hopefully get themselves over the line again.
Another player who's experienced first-grade football, Lachlan Burr, coming on now for the Bulldogs in jersey number 19.
Bit of a journeyman over the last few years, Burry, but it's great to have him back at the club. P2's a very, very handy football to pick up.
Nice 50-metre kick there, and here's Lachlan Burr bringing the football back. Campbell Gillard goes straight up into the front line to meet him one-on-one. Here's the Dogs. See, they're looking exciting at the moment, the Bulldogs. Really pushing hard.
It's a great read. Great read by Mansell there.
Dez is gone and now they're kicking.
Left. Ball goes to Lewis. Now in the hands once more of Burr. Just love the runs of Renoff Tolmunga. He's been strong today. He's Cleland on the short side. Kicks him behind the line. Mansell, he does not muck around one bit. Just bashes it over the dead ball line with his fist. And they'll have another goal line dropout here for the Panthers. The Bulldogs starting to pile on the pressure.
See, the Panthers have still got their three starting middles out there, and Merrin, Tamo, and Regan Campbell-Gillard. I think it's just starting to show on them. Tuamaga got a quick play of the ball. Off Ndiki earlier got a quick play of the ball, and just starting to attack against a resetting line or a retreating line as opposed to a set line. Starting to get their nose through a little.
I'm just not sure whether they've actually made any changes at all here, the Panthers.
I don't think they have.
It's a pretty incredible opportunity of those front rowers who like their 25-minute burst or their 17, 18-minute burst. They won't be loving this one bit.
Three internationals, though.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure they can handle it.
Pushing through
Tamo and Campbell-Gillard. He's Oakenball. Around about 3 minutes left on the clock here in the first half. Had a pretty good first half of footy to watch, too. Limited errors for us to see in trial matches. February footy, you always get those mistakes, but we're pretty impressed by how both teams have handled themselves with the ball in hand tonight.
Absolutely, it's been a great contest.
Should kick it at dummy half, holding up in the front line. Well handled here by Bergman. 3 metres away from the try line now, the Bulldogs. And again. throws a flat pass, maybe a little bit forward there, but it's play on in the hands of Josh Cleland, out on the wing to Tom Carr. And what about that? When the ball goes to ground, people usually fall asleep. But I've got to say, that pass had to be about a metre and a half forward on the ground.
Beware the bouncing ball. Yeah, look, it probably wasn't their greatest set there. They probably didn't throw a lot at them, but the ball hits the deck. Some people tend to stand still, and bounce of the ball went the dog's way.
Tell you what, Josh Cleland didn't muck around, did he? As soon as he saw that ball pop up in front of him, he pounced on it.
Oh, he's got great acceleration. Very fast.
And Tom Carr, the youngster, he picked him up at the Dogs maybe a couple of years ago now from the Illawarra Cutters.
Yeah, I think this is Tommy's second year. Yeah, he played OSP with the Cutters. Might have been the year they played in the national final. Tommy settled in nicely here. Really good outside back, got some great speed.
You certainly will remember the night he played at Belmore up against the NRL Panthers and got himself a try.
He sure will.
Been very impressive from the younger Bulldogs team, less experienced Bulldogs team, I should probably clarify. Garrett Holland tries to add the extra 2 points. Doesn't strike this one as nicely and has just pushed it out to the right-hand side. So the score is still 10 points to 6, but the Doggies in front going into half-time as it stands. But the Panthers, as we know, they've put themselves under pressure, played their same 13 for the whole of the first half. And no doubt Anthony Griffin will be looking to that bench in the second half. A couple of their players on the bikes, they've pretty much ridden the Tour de France down on the sideline. Keeping warm and ready.
I can imagine Big Sam McKendry's pretty keen to get out on the field. Fisher Harris and Timmy Brown as well against one of his old clubs, so I'm sure they'll get their chance.
When you rattle it off, a pretty impressive list of players that the Panthers have got.
It's a fair roster.
Still to take the field. Yeah, James Fisher Harris, you mentioned, Wonga Blake's out there, Corey Hutterer and Ira. Incredible players too, but as we mentioned also too, the Bulldogs list that aren't playing tonight. You consider some of those players: Moses Mbai, Brett and Josh Morris, Will Hopewadi. You got Marcelo Montoya, Kieran Foran, Aaron Woods, the two new signings, Michael Leisha, Aiden Tolman, Josh Jackson, Adam Elliott, David Clemmer. The list goes on of the players the Bulldogs have left out tonight. And guess what? They're still in front.
Yeah.
10 points. NRL.com. Brad Cook joined by the Bulldogs 20s coach, Brad Henderson. And we're just seeing the Panthers make their way out onto the field after a bit of a lengthy break there as the Bulldogs are on the field waiting for them for a good few minutes. Maybe they copped a little bit in the sheds from coach Anthony Griffin as his NRL full-strength team trails this Bulldogs team, where a lot of the players have been left out tonight, 10 points to 6. So certainly an interesting second half coming up here, and some changes obviously have been made. See Wonga Blake out there in the number 20 jersey, Corey Harawira Naira out there in the number 21 as well. No doubt we'll see a few more changes out there tonight for the Panthers. We'll see whether they'll come back big and strong here in the second half. The Panthers have the football in at the second half as they're charging it back out from their own end of the field. Here at Belmore Sports Ground, very, very warm conditions this evening. And there's the number 15, Sam McKendry, another one of the internationals playing here for the Penrith Panthers, spreading it out nice and early. Passes interchange from Cleary onto Yeo, now in the hands of Tyrone Peachy. This Bulldogs outfit have stood up nicely tonight as Josh Mansour comes across field here for the Panthers. Last tackle now to the right-hand side in the hands of Cleary. Pressure from Jaden Oakenbore. Coming across to Josh Bergham and gets in the hands there of Crichton, though. Christian Crichton can't hold on to the football. They'll turn the ball over and the Bulldogs will play the football 10 metres out from their own end of the line.
Yeah, he got first shot at it, didn't he? He just couldn't pull it in. Got over the top of Bergerman, though.
As mentioned, the Bulldogs, a lot of their NRL squad out tonight. They've pretty much got a full 17 NRL players squad and change sitting on the bench tonight. Team Pay has seen enough of them last week up in the sunny coast, and so they'll be getting nice and ready for a couple of weeks' time when the NRL proper kicks off. And aren't our fans ready for the season to get underway? Tell you what, they've had plenty of footy to watch over the last 12 months as well with the World Cup. And they're getting ready now for more footy in the NRL in a couple of weeks' time. Nice little step at the line there from Asapeli Fine. Gee, slow to get to his feet. Defence over the top. Harawira Naira there in defence. Here's the kick from the Bulldogs going towards the sideline. Dylan Edwards on the spot once again and brings the ball back for the Panthers. No doubt the coaching staff for the Bulldogs, Dean Pay, along with Dave Penner, Steve Antonelli, Steve Georgialis, who's been helping out tonight with the Intrust Super Premiership team. Brad, they'd be very happy.
Yeah, I think they would, mate. I think Steve Antonelli in particular would probably be happy, you know, to keep a team like Penrith to 6 points given their roster. And I think Steve Antonelli, I wouldn't say he'd be completely happy, but he'd be pleased with their effort, that's for sure. Steve's had a big focus on the boys' defence, tackle tech in particular, and he'd be liking what he's seeing.
Well, Panthers now on the attack. Maloney gets it out to Yeo, finds Peachy. Once again, good defence, and they've funneled him over the sideline as well. They really drifted nicely that time, Bulldogs in defence. Didn't find themselves under pressure. Nobody shooting up out of the line. Some great defence. And now they'll pack down the scrum with the ball in hand. Again, 10 metres out from their own line. Doing it nicely there, the Bulldogs in defence. But the Panthers, they tend to be shifting quite a little bit earlier. And they've got a huge pack, and we want to see them take that ball up through the middle. And Anthony Griffin allowing them to play this expansive football. And whether they'll turn the ball back on the inside, they've got those rangy back rowers. No James Fisher-Harris out on the team tonight, so looking forward to seeing some footy from Fisher-Harris.
Well, it worked so well for them in the first 15 to 20 minutes, didn't it? They were just hitting their leads, little changes of direction, getting some quick play the ball, and pushing through the middle really well. So I'm surprised they're trying to go around the Dogs now.
Tom Carr, one of the try scorers in the first half of the Bulldogs, takes the first one up. Every player really pushing for an opportunity to join this squad. This young man's been very impressive tonight so far, Jaden Ockenbur.
As has Lockie Burr too. Every time he carries, here he goes again. Nice little change of direction with Asapeli. Time Burr carries, he hits that line really hard.
And that short jinking step just before the line, it's really putting defenders out.
Not good late feet, hasn't he? Just absolutely gets off a shoulder well.
Ball out the back. Burr playing a bit of first receiving ball player at the moment, Lachlan Burr. It's a hell of a lot better than getting bashed every time you take it forward. Last tackle now for the Bulldogs. Josh Cleland gets on the outside of Merriman, who brings him down.
He's done a great
job. Isaiah Yeo, in fact, defensively. That's a great tackle out on the edge there for the Panthers on the last, and that forces the changeover. Cleland just getting himself caught there. He'll be very disappointed with that.
Yeah, he will be. Just a little bit of game control there. Really need to get that kick down the other end. Keep the pressure off us now all of a sudden. Penrith are pushing into our half.
Oh, incorrect play the ball here from Josh Mansour. Well, they are cracking down on the play the balls in 2018. Well, that's the edict that's being put out. And Peter Wallace having a few complaints. Greg Eastwood having a laugh at his expense.
Yeah, we've seen a lot of it in the lower grades already, whether it just be rolling the ball between the legs without making a genuine attempt to play the ball with your foot, as well as planting the ball. So putting the ball on the ground before you're on your feet and then playing it, they're not happy with that either. So looks like the crackdown's real. Only one so far though, so can't complain.
Absolutely. Bulldogs now on the attack. Leading 10 points to 6 here at Belmore. Nice home advantage for a lot of the boys who do some training here on the ground. And there's a run off to Omanga, who's been one of the best tonight for the Bulldogs. For Armando Brown, waits playing in the dummy half role this evening. The other back now. Beautiful work, Marshall King. Holland tries to spin away from one. And defence in from Cleary and Haruira and Ira. Oaken board, dummy half. Marshall King now, underneath for Burr. Setting up for something nice here, they are at the moment, the Bulldogs. Although, real slow play the ball there. Wallace was all over Burr. Oh, nice run up the middle by Eastwood. He has been keen tonight, hasn't he, the veteran?
He sure has.
He really wants to force his way into the NRL squad. Last tackle coming now at the back from Marshall. King goes through his hands. Finally gets the ball into Cleland. Doesn't want to be caught with it again. Drops it on the right foot. But Mansour right on the spot there for the Panthers. But there's a penalty coming in here.
Not running off the ball, did he?
Can't quite see the reasoning that the referee is giving there at the moment. Jared Sutton. Chris Butler now has the ball. It is a penalty here to the Bulldogs. They'll get another set of six. Morgan right there. Opportunity now for Reece Martin on the right edge. Scored the first try for the Bulldogs tonight. And he's just a few metres away from the try line. He's Tuomanga. He's got some big leg drive going in there. Takes three of the big Panthers pack in the middle to slow him down. Fisher-Harris is out there. Nice dart from dummy half. Luke Brown with some strength. Scores under the post for the Bulldogs again. Anthony Griffin won't be happy with the defensive effort there from the Panthers. And what about this? The understrength Bulldogs, they're in front now, 14 points to 6 up against the fancy Panthers. So it was Fisher-Harris slow to get away. McKendry, Edwards there, and New Brown just picked his mark there with Dylan Edwards. And plenty of strength. He wanted that, the new recruit out of the Sharks.
Yeah, Penrith camp wouldn't be happy with that. Good job at A defenders there, just to stop the nine. Bulldogs are set out to go to the left, so whether or not they were just anticipating the shift, but nice little play by Noon.
What about this from the Bulldogs? What about this crowd? That's a smallish crowd, no doubt, when they posted their team list leading into tonight. A lot of the fans would have been disappointed about not seeing their first grade players out there, but the ones who've turned up tonight, they've been rewarded with a fantastic performance tonight from these Bulldogs players. And anyone who's watching on NRL.com, you'll be enjoying what your Bulldogs are putting out tonight.
I think I told you during the break, Brad, this is, you know, I'm not surprised to be seeing what we're seeing. This is the way the boys have competed in their internal scrimmage and opposed sessions. So it gets pretty heated at times, but the boys really are competing as a group, and you've seen some good reward for how hard they've trained right now.
The Penrith Panthers getting not quite a lesson here from the Bulldogs, but they're certainly being reminded that there's a team of players who are very keen. We're training at more than a trial match. Here's the restart from James Maloney, taken here by young Jeremy Marshall King. It's Burr, I believe, again bringing a football back. They've all been ready for it. What about Burr returning the ball like a front rower, but then he stands first receiver using the football like a halfback? Although In past, a lot of Bulldogs forwards have been very skillful with the ball in hand, including this man, Greg Eastwood, again, menacing through the middle. Here's Reece Martin. Another good run here from the Bulldogs back row.
Really good meters getting made now. Getting themselves in a good kick position.
Tall Munger comes to the line with Wallace in front. Some good solid defence. Moses Leota out there now for the Panthers in the 19. Ball just trickling over the sideline there with Dylan Edwards hovering over it. Of course he was there on the right spot to wait for it, but allows it to go over the sideline, and there'll be a few players. Nice to take a break there with the warm conditions this evening at Belmore.
They've been doing most of the tackling too, Penrith, haven't they? So they'll be looking forward to a slow walk to the scrum, that's for sure.
You know, it's not one to harp on it, but you can imagine so many people watching this game or getting ready for this game tonight were expecting an absolute pasting for the Panthers over the Bulldogs tonight. And I tell you what, we've been rewarded with an absolute quality football match from a lot of these newish Bulldogs players and players wanting to crack into the NRL. It's just such a pleasure to watch these guys put in.
Yeah, it's pretty exciting. It's exciting for them, that's for sure. Just touched on it before, just a great reward for a really strong pre-season Dean has put it through.
And, the other side of it is Anthony Griffin worried at all? Whether he wants them to play this style of football? To see Wanga Blake bring the football back across field here for the Panthers?
I think all the signs were really good with Penrith early. You know, whether they've gone away from that too much, I'm not sure. But look, Penrith are the sort of team that can put a bit of pressure on you for 5 minutes and then blow you away as well. So still got a few more minutes to go yet.
Here's a kick and a catch there from Kerrod Holland. Nice work at the fullback. He's been very good tonight, Kerrod Holland. I mentioned his versatility before. Played a lot in the centres and out on the wing in some NRL over his 27 NRL game career. But playing some fullback in recent time.
So Jake Knockenbore's just been replaced by Jack Nelson. The Bulldog signings from Penrith Panthers, I believe.
A couple of those back and forths, haven't there been, for the Bulldogs and the Panthers?
Yes.
Tim Brown, not playing tonight. He was named, but he's been pulled from the Panthers list. Ty Phillips is out with that pec injury from the Bulldogs to the Panthers as well. So a couple of changes back across. And I guess that's the merry-go-round of rugby league. You've got to find your home however you can.
Yeah.
There's a penalty here for pressure on the neck of the player.
Can't get any sustained pressure at the moment, the Panthers. Bulldogs are doing a really good job to keep turning them away. Most of the football's been played down the Panthers' end.
Well, it's hard to win games of footy when you don't have the ball, and the Bulldogs are controlling it quite well here at the start of the second half. Just a few minutes gone. Score 16 points to 6. With 28 minutes remaining here in this second half into the match. The Bulldogs will enjoy the night tonight so far. He's in the hands now, pushing crossfield. He's tool out. Centre field now, the Bulldogs on the attack. New Brown waits underneath for Eastwood. Eastwood steps off that right foot, goes to the try line, Greg Eastwood. Can't quite get there. The big man's got a great right foot step. Come back out to the left-hand side. Marshall King throws the first man play. Good defence in there from the Panthers, who really muscled up. In the pass, not really on the spot there from Marshall King. So we'll see a scrum pack down here. I'm just going to see which way. He's saying it's a knock on both ways, but I think we'll see the ball go to the feet of the Panthers.
Yeah, I think Jack Nelson might have put that one down. Interesting to see a replay there, whether or not the Bulldogs had to strip the numbers out the back, but Penrith did well to get the bodies in front there.
Typical. I'll tell you now.
Marshall King, we haven't seen him run the football too much tonight, though, have we, Marshall King?
No, he's got it around the park. Probably of the two, Josh Clinton's a bit more of a ball runner between Jeremy and Josh. But Jeremy's had an outstanding pre-season. I know Dean particularly happy with him coming to the club. He's given us so much more depth in that position, that's for sure. Equally at home at nine as he is in the halves.
Oh, nice bit of expansive play. Sees Mansour away on the left-hand side. Beachy threw a nice ball to put him away. Oh, and then comes up with a simple error around the ruck. Tyrone Beachy is one of the most damaging footballers in broken play, and then just comes up with a simple little error like that, turns it back over to the Bulldogs and lets them off the hook.
just a bit indicative of their night, isn't it? It's, they just can't get that pressure on anymore. Joshy Cleland did a really good job to double defend then as well. So it looked like the Bulldogs were going for numbers and did well to get across and cut that down.
Plus also you've got to take a look at, because they made so many changes at half time now, these Panthers players have to get warmed up as well. So it's forcing them to come up against the ready, warmed up players of the Bulldogs team.
Yeah, they got some rhythm going at the moment, the Dogs, haven't they? Like you said, Panthers made so many changes. They start again.
Interesting to see what Dean Pay has in store for Farmanu Brown in 2018, because we know we've got Michael Leisha with the regenerated running game at hooker, and New Brown is certainly coming in with a lot of energy, could be pushing for maybe a bench spot, a utility spot.
Yeah, potentially.
Because we know he can play 6 and 7.
He's been really sharp. And yeah, the running game that Leisha has, you know, it's going to take something out of him. He's always been an outstanding defender, but we've all seen what he can do when he runs the ball as well, the back end of the year last year and the World Cup. So
on the attack now, the Dogs in the hands of Josh Cleland. Ball from Reece Martin, putting him under pressure there, and Peachy was on the spot to make the tackle. Last coming now for the Dogs, he's the kick across field from Brown. Vinay's there on the spot. Oh, bounces right off the hands. I think it may have been off John Olive's hands. Went straight into the breadbasket and popped straight out. And the ball comes back now to the changeover to the Panthers, but Olive had a chance to score there.
He did, yeah. And just another good indication of what New Brown can bring to the team. Just landed that right on the spot with a great kick. Trying to isolate the three men.
Oh, here's a great run here from Mansour. He just gives you so much go forward from the back. Isaiah Yeo is coming in to help out as well.
This is where they're dangerous. Start rolling in under the ruck.
And then gets the penalty for good measure. He's laying in a little bit too long there, and a quick tap here from Edwards. Tries to catch them off guard and picks up some nice metres centre field as well. Here's Wallace now at dummy half. The pressure's right on. Maloney spreads it out to Peachy. Tries to bounce on the outside, but he's brought down in a very good tackle. Lachlan Lewis back out there for the Bulldogs.
He's dumped it up.
Chase across to bring him down. He's the Panthers on the attack. We haven't seen too much of this in the second half. He's Cleary. Finds Maloney. Good defence. Hits him the Dogs. Now it comes out to Cleary again. Short pass. Arawira Naira. Can't get to the try line. Good defence here from the Bulldogs. Last tackle now. 5 metres away. Cleary has the football. Shapes the kick. Puts it in behind the line. And Cleland watches it over the dead ball line nice and closely. Cleary can't get there to chase his own kick. Great work from the Bulldogs. And now it's their turn to turn defence into attack. Nice work here from Tom Carr. The winger comes in to bring the ball. Nice 12-metre gain.
Just some great signs for the Dogs there. When Penrith got the penalty, it looked like they were starting to get underneath the ruck quite easily. Steve Antonelli would be wrapped with that defensive set they just came up with. It. Real good bodies in front. Very physical.
Good support also too. Bergerman and Olive taking the finger. Ready to back up the great play from Tom Carr from that right edge to allow. Now in the hands of Eastwood, who's owned the centre third tonight for the Bulldogs. Back on the inside. Nice bit of play here, and that's from Jack Nelson. Last play now coming for the Dogs. They lead 16 points to 6. Left foot kick in there from Lewis. Will it sit up? Crichton's got some work to do here, and then takes the ball over the dead ball line. Pressure there on Christian Crichton. A good chase there from the Dogs. And Lincoln Lewis, on the limited opportunities he's had to kick tonight, they've always been on the spot.
Yeah, true. Yeah, probably that little bit of game control was missing at the start of the game for him. But New Brown, Lockie Lewis, Josh Cleland, some of their intercepts have been great.
I think I pretty much named him after his cousin then, did I? Lincoln.
I think you did, yeah.
I did. I wonder if he's an actor as well. Pretty sure he can do anything tonight. He can Lachlan Lewis.
I'm sure he'd back you up there.
Well, he's got the pedigree there, the nephew of the king, Wally. I wonder whether Lincoln would want to play footy as good as Lachlan. I'm sure he'd love to.
I'm sure he would.
He's off a Hickey Ogden now. They picked up the Bulldogs from the Warriors for this year. Now winding up again, Lachlan Burr. Some good footy here for the Bulldogs. They are very intent tonight on putting their best foot forward for Coach Dean Pay to check them out. possible honours this year in the NRL up against this star-studded Panthers lineup. Back on the open side now, spinning around, playing that first receiver role again. Got his hands on the footy a few times tonight, Lachlan.
That's all right, that's all right.
Get up! To the left, through Lewis, finds Holland. Holland tries to get on the outside of Cleary. Some good defence, helped out by Wonga Blake.
Yeah, they've got the numbers in front well every time the Dogs come to their left.
Who was that? That's happening hard.
They have the last option now. Olive waits at dummy half. Into the hands of Lewis. Kicks him behind. Another great kick there from Lachlan Lewis. Now the ball comes back out. Panthers doing well through James Maloney. He's copped a couple of bumps tonight, James Maloney. He's a little bit sticky up from this one as well.
Got a knee in the back, maybe accidentally. Great read on the kick by Maloney, just showing his experience there. Tough play to get it out of in goal as well.
He played not a lot of minutes against the Roosters last week, or certainly not the full game for James Maloney. But this week, having plenty of work to do tonight. Well, another mistake from the Panthers, and it's that man again, is it Tyrone Peachy at dummy half, but it may have been a mistake from the fullback there in Dylan Edwards.
Dylan Edwards, yeah.
Playing the football. Look at the Bulldogs come together. These youngsters, very proud of their efforts so far, they are, and come together as a squad and pat each other on the back. They know they're in front here, 16 points to 6, 20 minutes remaining in the trial, and they're a chance here of knocking off the Fancy Panthers.
Go!
It's really important to let us stick to process. What they're doing really well is execute Dino's game plan. He'd be stoked with that, but as long as they don't keep looking at the scoreboard, keep looking at the clock and just roll through our processes. A good chance to steal on this.
Not fucking James Bowen taking a fucking hit up from the scrum. That's how you attack from a scrum.
On the attack now through the scrum wing. Lewis has the football out the back of Holland. Nice big football. Oh, nice work. Bergerman for the corner. And Josh Bergerman scores the try. Great work here from the Dogs. He's put in tonight under high balls. Been under pressure tonight, Josh Bergerman, and now picks up a nice try off the scrum move from the Dogs.
And it's just been that pressure, hasn't it? Unrelentless. And unforced errors from the Panthers too. You can see the Panthers centre there might be Wonga Blake got caught in. Nice tip on from what could have been Dutchie Holland, I think. Put Josh Bergerman into the clear to get over in a foot race in the corner. Really nice execution. And again, great reward. Some good end of sets by the Bulldogs. Keeping the pressure on, not letting the Panthers out of their half. They're doing a great job.
One thing that a lot of clubs and a lot of fans look for is depth. And we're certainly seeing it here tonight for the Bulldogs.
Yeah, we are too. It's probably a little bit of a coming of age for some of the kids that have been with the club for a while as well. Add to that some good recruitment from Warren McDonald also. There's brought some real footballers to the club, some real competitive guys also. So.
I'm not sure there's too many game aware cheerleaders here at the moment because they're pretty much standing right on top of Rhys Martin as he's ripping his conversion.
Might be alright with that.
He's finally got his space now to his conversion over from the sideline. Picked up the kicking duties from Kerrit Holland. PNG International. Let's see what this kick looks like from the grandstand side. He's kicked it alright, but just pushed it to the left-hand side. And the score remains 20 points to 6. The Bulldogs lead the Panthers here in the trial at Belmore Sports Ground. When you do look at the games that they've got, the Bulldogs have got a pretty tough draw leading off the start of the year. They've got a tough one up the start against the Melbourne Storm. That's over at Perth at the doubleheader. And then they've got the Roosters away. They play against this Panthers team at home. And then they take on the Rabbitohs at their home ground, but it's a South Sydney home ground match. Then the Raiders in Canberra, and then the Cowboys up there in North Queensland. So a pretty tough start to the season for the Bulldogs.
Yeah, sure is. Don't get any harder than playing the Melbourne Storm, the defending premiers round one. And they've had a really busy pre-season with three tough trials, one in-house trial against Newcastle behind closed doors, obviously the World Club Challenge, and then the JT and Camp Show last night up at Suncorp Stadium. So, you know, they're match hardened already. So it's a tough way to start the year, but it's what a good way to get a read on where you're at.
And equally for the Panthers, in their first six rounds of the competition, they actually play the Eels twice in the first five rounds, in fact. They got the Eels at home, then they play the Rabbitohs at home in round two. Then they've got the Bulldogs match, as mentioned. They take on the Cowboys up in North Queensland. And then the Eels again at home, and then the Titans at home as well. Sorry, the Eels game is away at ANZ Stadium.
Another good end of set, good kick chase by the Bulldogs, keeping that pressure on.
Well, the Panthers have got plenty of work to do here as they trail by 14 points with 15 minutes remaining here in the trial match.
Look like they're about to roll out a few of their internationals again. James Tarmo and Trent Merritt warming up on the sideline.
Yeah, they've got a plethora of big boys and of international experience playing out there for the Panthers tonight. Down the short side play now from the Panthers. Beautiful interchange play. Finds Peachy on a mantle, but they just ran out of room down there, the Panthers. See what they have now as they come back through the centre. Ball goes onto the boot, kicked over the sideline. Will it? No, it goes dead in goal. Oh, it sat up, can you believe it? I could stop a train, and I have done so there as the ball stood right in the corner and picked up there by the Bulldogs. In the end, it was a great kick.
Probably just a disappointing chase in the end to let the Bulldogs still get it out 10 metres. So probably where the Panthers are at the moment. The energy just not quite where they want it to be, maybe.
Here's Lewis to play the football. John Olive now comes in for a run. Another play with NRL experience out here tonight for the Bulldogs. Now they go through Asipeli Fine. Some great footwork from Asipeli. Last play now comes back for the kick from Lewis. Off the side of the boot there for Lewis. Do well to stay in the field of play and just bounces once, twice, and then three times over the sideline. Not the greatest of kicks, but no doubt his forwards will love the break. And they'll pack down a scrum 30 metres away from the Panthers' line, and they trail 14 points here, the Panthers, to the Dogs.
Yeah, not a textbook kick, that one, boy, Lockie, but not the worst result in the end. The change is coming again. Kick out looks like he's coming back on.
And as we mentioned, for those watching and listening to us here on NRL.com, Brad Henderson with me is the 20s coach for the Bulldogs, so giving us great insight tonight for the Dogs. What are the first grade players doing tonight who aren't playing here? Are they watching here?
Yeah, they're all here. Yeah, there might be some down in the dugout. I've seen a few signing autographs. Speaking to David Clipper a bit earlier, I think he's hurting not playing, but I think he gets it too. You'd play every day if you could, probably, Big Clem. But yeah, they're all hereabouts. I know Josh Jackson was here from the first game watching Harold Matt, so he's been here all day, our club captain, and which is just fantastic to see. He's a great man, Jacko.
A great appointment when it was announced. He's the Panthers on the attack. Oh, Wonga Blake can't hold onto the ball from the pass there of Edwards. It was on there too for the Panthers a couple of times now. Just then down the right side, but previously twice on the left. They've looked very dangerous. They just can't string those last passes together, the Panthers.
They've been so close, haven't they? But to the Dogs' credit, they've still got bodies around the ball, so they're surviving.
Les Campbell-Gillard. Yeah. Every time we see him in the middle, he has run out of the line with intent to hurt. Very strong footy from Regan Campbell-Gillard now down around the legs. So he's putting in. Doggies on the attack now. He's Nelson out the back, finds Lewis. Short pass to Fine. Wonga Blake does well to come in and help out in defence. To the open side now. He's Lachlan Burr. Tries to push away from Cleary, looking to get his arm free as well. But the offload King and Merrin knew that and somehow held onto the football. Last tackle short side. Holland puts the kick in behind the line. Opportunity bounces up into the hands of Josh Bergerman, who gets a double. Christian Crichton couldn't hold onto the footy there and ground it. And the Bulldogs have themselves another try, courtesy of the winger.
It's like every error the Panthers are coming up with is getting punished, and the Dogs are good enough to capitalise. Great little end of set by Dutchie Holland here on the short side, threading it through. Johnny Olive and Josh Bergerman just competing harder. Good
forward. Poor old Christian Crichton there. Just couldn't quite bat the ball down over the dead ball line. You saw Tyrone Pidgey have trouble with it earlier on. And he had a little bit of trouble with it there too. And a second try coming now for Josh Bergerman. They are putting on a show now, these youngsters from the Bulldogs.
It's a really hard kick to defend that one too. Crichton obviously has to get up and get in front in case they throw the long ball, but then you have to turn and try and get in the foot race with the chasers. They've probably got the advantage on either shoulder. Just got in ahead of him. Great play by the Dogs. Smart play.
So still 10 minutes to go, so plenty of footy remaining, and if this kick is missed by Holland, it's three converted tries for the Panthers to bring back. But how does this affect the mindset now of Anthony Griffin and his Penrith Panthers? A lot has been spoken about players shifting from the club. We've got a team now who's playing up against a team where they're not really NRL players in the eyes of the coach just as yet. So they're in a tough spot here mentally, the Panthers.
Yeah, they are. And it's hard to comment if you don't know the dynamic at the club, of course. But, you know, it could also be that little kick in the bum that they maybe they might need, you know, and I'm sure there'll be a reaction on the back of this. I've got an idea.
Well, as a physical head out, it's certainly been a good one for the Panthers. There've been plenty of collisions out there in the middle, so they'll be accustomed to that.
Yeah, look, they've probably got what they need out of it. I don't think they would have been coming here thinking, look, we have to win this game. You know, get some valuable game time for what we know is an outstanding pack with two outstanding halves.
And I think every single fan going into round one says you don't listen to trial form. You don't care about trial form. It really doesn't matter that much. And to be honest, I am one of those people. But what we've seen tonight, this Bulldogs team of young people, they're keen to play and try and force their way into the NRL squad.
100%.
Whereas the Panthers players, I don't know whether I'm seeing that on the other side.
No, you try and tell a first grade footballer that, you know, a trial doesn't matter. If they're in a game of rugby league, they just want to win. Because every little moment is a contest. And, you know, they've just got a lot of really good little wins today that have added up to a great result so far.
Bulldogs with the football taking on the Panthers side of halfway. And the Panthers find themselves under pressure. With the Bulldogs with the footy, he's Lachlan Lewis, who's been very good tonight for the Dogs. As has this man for the Panthers, Dylan Edwards. Nice kick chase from the man who kicked it down there from Lewis. And he's Christian Crichton bringing the ball back for the Panthers.
Some of their intercept kicks in this half by the Bulldogs have been really good, just keeping that pressure on. Just going for the big play, going for the smart play.
There's a nice tackle there from Nelson, getting a little bit of help. Pressure there on Trent Merrin. Haven't seen much of Bronson Garlick out there tonight for the Bulldogs. No opportunity yet for Bronson. Likewise, no Joel Luani, Darice Miller, Mason Cerruto. All listed to come on for the Bulldogs tonight, but still haven't seen them out on the field.
Yeah, I believe all three. Might have played quite a bit of time in the OSP.
The ball goes up and down off the hands of Kerrick Holland. The crowd don't believe it's gone forward, but Chris Butler was on the spot, and he was very happy to call that knock-on from the Bulldogs. Sees the Panthers with an opportunity here now to try and cross the stripe here in the second half. Still no points from the Panthers in the second half, and just over 7 minutes remaining in this trial match.
Interesting to see how patient they are too. They haven't been down here, if at all, in this half, so whether or not they chase the points or they just try and build a little bit of pressure and see if they can build some points.
It's also interesting to see then that if those four players do not take the field, that Dean Pay's only used 18 players tonight for the Bulldogs so far in this 73 minutes of play. Here's Dylan Edwards out the back now for the Panthers. Gee, nice tackle underneath from Josh Cleland.
Yeah, the clock's ticking by, so it's not looking very likely.
This time it's a charge forward from the Panthers in Viliami kick out. He's Cleary. Cleary off the right foot, goes himself. Trying to spark something here, Nathan Cleary. Oh, and a penalty comes, just holding down too long. Sione Katoa was just waiting, ready to get the football. He had plenty of plans for it as well. Here he is now with the football, Katoa. He was a He stands and tries to get the football away, but the Dogs' defence is up to the task. Out wide now goes to Cleary. Finds Maloney, 7 and 6 combined. Short play on to Edwards. Finds Wonga. Blake, has he got the strength? Blake goes for the line. They spin him over onto his back, and he's been held up. Some great defence there from the Bulldogs, or some very enterprising play from the halves and the fullback.
Well, he did everything but get it down, Wonga Blake. He's a big body too. Would have been really hard to keep up there. So the Dogs did well to get numbers under the ball, get in front of the ball, then get under it.
Cleary now again. Finds Merrin, who steps and picks up some pace towards the line. Marshall King in defence. Goes long, Katoa into Maloney, short play. No way for the try line again here for the Panthers. Football played back. Gamble Gillard, first receiver. He says, I'm not supposed to be here. Puts the ball under the arm and goes hard and forward. Last tackle now coming for the Panthers. They go out the back. Cleary finds Edwards. Tip on play again from Blake onto Crichton. He gets to the try line. Beautiful footy that time for the Panthers, who hold onto the ball and score the four-pointer. Nice work there from the Penrith Panthers.
Yeah, it was really good, wasn't it? You could see all the indicators spread out to the right-hand side there. You knew which way they were coming. But sometimes, particularly on your try line, it's just really hard to get those bodies in front. Beautiful tap on from Naiwira, I believe. And great job by Crichton to get over in the corner. So from Wonga Blake, was it? Great hands just to tap that pass on. Get him over in the corner. Penrith are probably just looking to get 4 minutes of good football.
What a head!
Under their belt. Get away with something to be happy about. Get to their kick a couple of times. Get some good defensive sets on. Put some pressure on the young Dogs and maybe get an error again.
Yeah, there's certainly no questioning the talent or the skills that's on display. It's just been that last drop ball or push pass that's forced the error as Cleary comes in for the kick. Pushes that one out to the right-hand side.
Yeah, they've been close, haven't they, a couple of times. And like you said, the last pass has hurt them. And look, they've let themselves down at the play the ball a couple of times as well, so just a little indiscretions there.
Bulldogs 24 lead the Panthers 10 with 3.5 minutes remaining here in the week 3 trial. Just 2 weeks away from the NRL season proper. Both teams having their final hit out for 2018 to prepare for their first round match. As mentioned, the Panthers have the Eels at home and the Bulldogs have the Storm in Perth for round one. It's the restart from the Dogs. Nice deep one. It's going to go over the dead ball line on the full, and there'll be a penalty back on halfway. It's a little bit too much enthusiasm on that kick, and the Panthers will have another opportunity to cross the line.
Well, it's taken 37 minutes, but there's been two penalties in a row now, so back-to-back penalties. See if the Panthers can go back-to-back on points.
Here's Wonga Blake. Restart things for the Panthers. Well, that's interesting.
Yeah, I don't understand that.
It's a bad habit. It felt good at training, so we have to do it in the real game. Oh, hilarious. Sometimes you wonder whether players know the rules.
Creatures of habit, aren't they?
They are. Yeah. Here's the play from Katara out the back. Merrin finds Maloney. Beautiful tackle underneath, but kick out. Kicks out of it and almost goes towards the try line. Good strength there from Billy Army. Kick out. Oh, another penalty over the top. Pushing down too much that time was Jared Anderson, forcing the penalty. And the Panthers one more time on the attack. 2 minutes remaining. He's Cleary. Nice pass. Fisher-Harris. Limited opportunities with the football tonight, James Fisher-Harris. Oh, jeez. And then Asad Billy Finau just jumped on the back of him and was allowed to play on. Here's Merrin. A bit comical at the end here tonight, the play. And now Merrin's still standing. He's forced to play the ball. Good quick one, Katoa. Finau comes up out of the line again, putting too much pressure on.
Yeah, it could be 10 minutes in this.
That's twice he's given away. He almost should have been penalised one tackle ago.
Yeah. It's a bit of a crackdown from the refs, I think, with this sort of play where they know the defensive team tend to give a penalty away, back themselves to defend another set of six, but they got away with it.
James Tarmo now had limited opportunities as well. So as we've mentioned, Coach Griffin hasn't necessarily played all players to their full extent tonight. It is only a trial match. And hope that he's got what he needs out of his players going up against the Eels in round one. He's the spread now, Campbell Gillard. 5 metres away from the try line are the Panthers. They'd love to cross the stripe one more time tonight. Out the back finds Cleary. Short pass, Fisher-Harris. Nice defence underneath from the Bulldogs in Lewis. Who's forced a mistake, maybe Lachlan Lewis. He's been tremendous tonight for the Bulldogs. Here's Cleary. Long pass, Campbell Gillard again. Nice step from Merrin. Can't quite get away. Good defence underneath. Reece Martin was the man, along with Cleland. They go short now. Maloney gives a beautiful pass long. Tyrone Peachy's almost monstered to the ground, but Orange is over the back. It's play on here for the Panthers.
Flag up on the sideline.
Just stepped over the sideline in Tyrone Peachy. And the Bulldogs fans, they all stand on their feet. Gee, they're really enjoying themselves tonight. Happy with the performance of these inexperienced Bulldogs players who've played tonight.
Whatever
they bring themselves, a really, really strong win tonight at home at Belmore.
Yeah, they should be proud. What a great read by Tommy Carr on the wing there to come in and jam, cut that play off. Probably stopped certain 4 points there. Really good decision.
Well, you can see the players in the trial match. Clock just winding down the final seconds. Certainly no rush for the players to restart play. And what has been a very warm evening here at Belmore. And certainly maybe warm in the dressing rooms if Anthony Griffin hasn't been happy with what he's seen tonight from his Penrith Panthers. But I know there'll be one elated Dean Pay, the new coach for the Canterbury Bulldogs, who has seen his less experienced players in the squads that come out tonight and put on a fine performance, winning 24 points to 10 in this trial match at Belmore. Tries to Reece Martin, Tom Carr, Fa'amanu Brown, and a double to Josh Bergman in the second half. And also tries for the Panthers from Regan Campbell-Gillard and Christian Crichton tonight. So 5-2, the Bulldogs over the Panthers. And Brad Henderson, final comments from you. Are you happy with the performance of the Bulldogs tonight?
Oh, of course, yeah. Yeah, I always say I'm surprised, but yeah, I guess probably I am a little bit, but given the roster Penrith put out there, but you know, I've seen how hard they've worked in the pre-season.
Down the corner.
Oh no, on the string.
Yeah.
Dinner's ready for me. See in a couple of weeks, two?
Yeah, two.
Three, is it? So we got a week off, is it?
Oh, it'll be about another 4 weeks before we're at ANZ. From now.
When's Perth? Next Perth, week, the week after.
Perth's round one, then Roosters. Then round three, we're at ANZ.
Where's Roosters, though?
Alley.
Yeah, you done Alley, I'll tell you. Of course. It's only 2 minutes.
We'll go there and break their fucking balls, mate.
I was ripping the string. So you could see, Colin on that down here. It was only like about 30 seconds out. I put the first one up. It already had about 1.2k already booked at it. But I've got to change the title because it gets copyright.
Oh, of course, yeah.
I don't think I need to fucking stop it.